subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 20th of September. Saudi Arabia Foreign Minister calls on Indian Prime Minister Modi in New Delhi. JUIF Chief Fazlur Rahman says Pakistan must recognize Taliban government. And festival season returns as Indra Jatra celebrated with fanfare in Nepal. And now for all the details. Foreign Minister of Saudi Arabia Prince Faisal bin Farhad Al Saud on Monday called on Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in capital New Delhi and held talks on issues of mutual interest. Prince Faisal is on a three-day visit to India and his visit comes days after he batted for the Taliban regime in Afghanistan, hoping that the caretaker government will help the war-torn nation achieve stability and overcome violence and extremism. Prince Faisal on Sunday also met Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar. This was the first ministerial visit from Saudi Arabia to India since the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic. Both ministers discussed all issues related to their bilateral relationship and regional and international issues of mutual interest. They also reviewed the implementation of the Strategic Partnership Council agreement signed between the two sides during the visit of Prime Minister Modi to Saudi Arabia in October 2019. They also exchanged views on the developments in Afghanistan and other regional issues. Several states in India on Monday reopened schools for students, including for those in the primary level, as fresh COVID-19 infections have showed a declining trend. Meanwhile, the South Asian nation crossed yet another milestone in its COVID vaccination drive on Monday, with the total doses administered so far crossing the 810 million mark.
Several states in India on Monday reopened schools for students, including for those in the primary level, as coronavirus cases have showed a declining trend in recent days. In Jaipur city in northwestern Rajasthan state and Bhopal in central Madhya Pradesh, schools opened for students from class 1st to 5th after the state governments gave nod to phased reopening at 50% capacity. India had in March 2020 ordered the closure of all educational institutions and pushed for classes to move online to curb the spread of the deadly virus. In northern Jammu and Kashmir territory, students of classes 10th and 12th also attended schools on Monday, adhering to COVID-19 protocols issued by authorities. A student expressed happiness over rejoining school for physical classes, as online classes had their own hassles.
ऑनलाइन में हमें काफ़ी डाउट्स आते थे, वो हम क्लियर भी नहीं कर पाते थे क्योंकि टीचर को बाकी बच्चों का भी देखना होता था, तो मतलब नेटवर्क इशू हद से ज़्यादा, क्योंकि जिनके घर वाईफाई नहीं उनको काफ़ी प्रॉब्लम होती थी। स्कूल की तरफ से भी काफ़ी नेटवर्क इशू आता था, तो अब हम जब स्कूल आए हैं तो हमें एक एडवांटेज है कि हम सारे मतलब डाउट्स क्लियर कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि इतने बच्चे आ नहीं रहे हैं अभी, तो मतलब ये काफ़ी बड़ा एडवांटेज है हमारे लिए, तो यही सोच कर मैं आई हूँ आज।
India's COVID-19 cases tally stood at 33.47 million as of Monday, with 445,133 deaths so far. Meanwhile, the South Asian nation crossed yet another milestone in its COVID vaccination drive on Monday, with the total vaccination crossing the 810 million mark. The health ministry said the COVID recovery rate in the country now stands at 97.68%.
Moving on. Locals in Pakistan's financial capital, Karachi, have expressed they are upset over the fuel price hike by the government last week, which has raised worries of another subsequent rise in prices of essential commodities. Opposition parties have also slammed the government over the move amid an all-time high inflation.
Locals in Pakistan's Karachi city have expressed anger over the recent fuel price hike by the government, which has raised their worries amid rising inflation. The Pakistan government last week increased the price of both petrol and diesel by rupees 5 per litre, taking the current price of petrol to rupees 123.30 and diesel to 120.04 rupees per litre. Locals lamented the fuel price hike will now further affect the prices of food and other essential commodities as they are transported via road. They said they have become weary of the Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government.
गवर्नमेंट तो यानी अपने पैसे बढ़ाई जा रही है, लेकिन आवाम के ऊपर इतना लोड डालती जा रही है, उसका क्या हल है? ये हल है कि आप यानी आवाम को मजीद दबाते जाएं, तो इससे क्या होगा? आवाम फिर बहुत ज़्यादा बेजार आ गई है इस हुकूमत से। तो
पेट्रोल में बढ़ना नहीं चाहिए। असल में देखो, आजकल हालात देखो किस तरह चल रहे हैं, लोग बेरोज़गार हैं, रोज़गार भी इंसान के पास नहीं है, तो लोग परेशान हैं। इस वजह से चाहिए कि पेट्रोल बढ़ना नहीं चाहिए। अगर पेट्रोल बढ़ेगा तो हर चीज़ हर शे में बढ़ती मतलब होगा, तो हर चीज़ बढ़ेगा।
Meanwhile, Pakistan's opposition parties have also slammed a move to increase fuel prices. Opposition leader in the National Assembly and the PMLN party president Shehbaz Sharif said today people are unable to afford basic necessities of life due to the incompetent and corrupt government. Pakistan People's Party chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari in a statement said the entire nation is crying due to record inflation and to get rid of it in the ruling PTI-led government must be sent home.
More news from Pakistan. Pakistan's Jamiat Ulema-Islam Fazl Party Chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman has urged Islamabad to immediately recognize the Taliban government to bring stability to war-torn Afghanistan. Pakistan, which wields considerable influence with the Taliban, has indicated support for an inclusive government in Afghanistan and has said it is in touch with the group.
Pakistan's Jamiat Ulema-Islam Fazl Party Chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman has urged Islamabad to immediately recognize the Taliban government to bring stability to war-torn Afghanistan. According to local media reports, Rahman, who is also the president of multi-party opposition alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement, said on Sunday that recognizing the Taliban is like recognizing Afghanistan, and that helping the Taliban required an immediate recognition of their government. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan announced this past weekend on Twitter that his government has started negotiations with the Taliban to form an inclusive government in Afghanistan. In recent days, Islamabad has also called on the international community to unfreeze assets and continue to provide foreign aid to Afghanistan as it faces an economic meltdown. Pakistan, which enjoys considerable influence with the Taliban, was often accused by the former Afghanistan government led by President Ashraf Ghani of giving the Taliban military aid, a charge denied by Islamabad.
For the Taliban, who took control of Afghanistan last month, the growing economic hardship is emerging as their biggest challenge. With a sinking currency and rising inflation, residents in Afghan capital are plagued by economic crisis under the new rule.
More than a month after Taliban swept into power, the group faced daunting problems as they seek to convert their victory into a durable peacetime government and as Afghan residents start to feel the economic crunch. Impromptu markets where people sell household goods for cash have sprung up across Kabul, with many pushing their wares on carts through heavy traffic, but buyers are in short supply. While much attention in West has focused on whether the new Taliban government will keep its promises to protect women's rights or offer shelter to militant groups like Al-Qaeda, for many Afghans the main priority is simple survival. Officials say the Taliban government is working to get services up and running again and that the streets are now safe. But as the war recedes, resolving the economic crisis is looming as a bigger problem. The new Taliban regime has also promised to allow women more freedoms, but there have been reports of women being barred from going to work. Earlier on Sunday, a group of Afghan women held rally outside the former building of the Women's Ministry in Kabul in a demonstration that demanded for women's rights in political participation and education. The protest came a day after some Afghan girls returned to primary schools with gender-segregated classes. But older girls faced an anxious wait with no clarity over if and when they would be able to resume their studies at the secondary school level.
Indra Jatra, one of the most celebrated festivals, is being observed in Nepal with fanfare. The procession of the week-long festival formally began with the elevation of sacred wooden pole in Basantpur Darbar, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, over the weekend. As part of the festival, Nepal's living deities, including Goddess Kumari, began touring of inner areas of the capital, which signals the arrival of the festival season in the Himalayan nation. Nepal's living deities, Goddess Kumari, Ganesh and Bhairav from Sunday started the tour of inner areas of capital Kathmandu as a part of the Indra Jatra festival, which signals the arrival of the festive season in the Himalayan nation. Ascension of three living deities in form of humans on chariots, which tours around city, is an annual festival observed for 1 week. Thousands of devotees from around Kathmandu Valley poured down into the premises of Basantpur Darbar Square, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, to witness the celebration as well as pay homage to the living gods in human form, despite the risk of a new variant of COVID-19. Last year, the festival was postponed due to the pandemic.
एकदम रामलाई फर्स्ट टाइम हेरेको थियौँ अनि त्यसपछि आफ्नै अब हुन्छ नि हाम्रो नेपालको त यस्तो राम्रो परम्परा छ होइन आफ्नै अगाडि आँखा अगाडि भगवान्लाई मानिन्छ अनि त्यो हेर्दाखेरि चाहिँ राम्रो लाग्यो त्यही हो
This year, the procession formally began with the elevation of a lingam, sacred wooden pole in Basantpur Darbar Square on Saturday. Various famous master dancers, folk drama and chariot processions created an atmosphere of fun and merriment.
Ramro lagyo. Dherai barsha bhayeko thiyo na naheryeko ani aba kati hernu pauncha ra bhanera ani yespali aago hernulai.
Legends say that Indra Jatra festival is observed to celebrate the victory of gods over the demons to release Jayanta, the son of rain god Lord Indra. It is believed that Lord Indra came to the earth to collect white flowers for his mother, but was caught by the locals, the Nevar of the Kathmandu Valley. After Lord Indra's identity was disclosed, they took out a procession which is continued till now. Apart from the Kathmandu Valley, Kavre and the Dholakhat district of the country also celebrate this festival with fervor. Scores of Hindu devotees gathered in India's holy cities of Gaya and Prayagraj on Monday to pay homage to the departed souls of their ancestors to mark Pitrupaksh or Ancestors' Fortnight. They offered prayers and food items as part of traditional rituals to free the departed souls from the cycle of life and death.
Scores of Hindu devotees gathered in India's eastern Gaya city on the banks of Falgu River to offer special prayers on the first day of Pitrupaksh for the salvation of the souls of their ancestors. According to the Hindu tradition, Pitrupaksh or Ancestors' Fortnight is a 16 lunar day period which is considered an inauspicious time to start a new venture. Hindus believe that performing special prayers during this period can help their forefathers and ancestors attain peace and salvation. As part of rituals, they prepare pints or dumplings and keep them at river banks as offering.
अपने पितरों को कुल में जितने भी लोगों हैं, सबको स्वर्ग पहुंचाने में तो अच्छे वो देने के लिए हम लोग आए हैं आस्था लेकर के अब ये पुरखों पुरानियों से परंपराएं चली आ रही हैं अपने पुरखों को यहाँ श्राद्ध देते हैं लोग पुराने जमाने से ही लोग हम लोग सुनते चले आ रहे हैं
Similar scenes were witnessed in Prayagraj city in India's northern Uttar Pradesh state, where devotees were seen taking a holy dip in river Ganges and offering special food items to their ancestors at the river's banks. In view of the pandemic, Pitrupaksh is being observed under strict COVID-19 protocols in the city. Some devotees also got their hands tonsured on the occasion as mark of respect for their ancestors.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.